What's going on, guys? I have a short story for you. The frustration is real. I don't know if you can feel it through the video, but I am frustrated, annoyed. So let me start from the top. It's actually, most of my frustration has something to do with what I'm about to talk. It's completely unrelated. In other words, it's something that I can't really talk about on camera. I can't explain why, but I was like borderline frustrated, and then I just got home, sitting in my car in my driveway, and then I got a text message about something else that is unrelated, and it just brought me to the next level of frustration. So the part that was not so frustrating in the beginning was going down to the post office. So I have a package here that I wanted to ship, and normally when I ship packages for things, I use prepaid labels. It just makes it easier. And this time, because of the shape and size and everything, it's not prepaid, so I had to get it. Wait, I had to go down to the post office. Now, my post office is like 20, 25 minutes away on a good day. It's windy, wooded roads, and today there happened to be a bunch of construction on the road. So I left early to make sure I was going to get there on time and everything, and I ended up coming across some road construction, which is no big deal. That shouldn't really be frustrating. It just, they have to fix the roads. Sometimes there's traffic. That's what it is. So I sat there for about, I don't know, 2 minutes, and then finally my lane was able to go. So I'm driving down the road even more, and then there's more traffic because they're cutting trees. Now today happens to be an extremely windy day, like 40 mile an hour gusts, tree branches everywhere, down, trees down, obviously places. Extremely, extremely windy, very cold as well. So I guess the tree went down or whatever, they had to cut it. So now I'm sitting again about 5-6 minutes or so in traffic. Not frustrated yet. It is what it is. You know, it's out of my hands. So then I finally get to the post office. Now my 20 to 25 minute ride is now like 30 minutes to 35 minutes. I'm ready to ship my item. I go to walk in, and the doors are shut. They are closed for lunch, which I did not know. Now, that could be pretty frustrating, but still, not their fault. They closed for lunch. I just didn't know that. I should have had the foresight to maybe call or find that out. This is a post office I go to occasionally, but I haven't really gone around lunchtime. So apparently, they're closed between 11 and 12. Now, lunchtime closing is usually 12 to 1, but hey, I'm not going to complain. So now this is the third thing that kind of went wrong. But again, it's not super frustrating. It's just, this is life. Things happen. So it's about 45 minutes wait for their lunch hour. I'm 15 minutes into their lunch break when I arrived. So I had to make the decision. Should I go home through the traffic again just to have a wasted day? I'm like, no, just wait it out. So I did. I waited there for 45 minutes. And when my 45 minutes was up, and by the way, I'm watching like 30 or 40 people come and go. I didn't realize they were closed either. The time has finally elapsed. I'm like an hour and a half into my journey of trying to ship this package. And when I walk in, the woman stops everyone and says, well, I just want to give everyone a warning. There is no power. So the power's out. Now, what that means is that if you have a PO box there, you can pick up your packages. Her scanner worked fine. But you can't do any shipping, can't buy stamps, can't do anything that involves the register, which is where the power is or should be. So I'm like, I can't believe it. So now I'm getting like, I'm this much frustrated now. I'm like, okay, well, you know, I waited a long time to get here and got here early, didn't know they were closed, and waited even longer for them to open. And now I can't ship my package. So again, this is not the end of the world. I figured, you know what, let me just wait it out. I have so much invested now into shipping this package that I'm going to wait another 10 minutes. Maybe the power will come back on. Not a big deal. Actually, while I was waiting, I noticed the outside lights were flickering on and off, and I thought someone was hitting a switch, but obviously it was the power coming on and off. So I thought to myself, self, let's just wait another 10 minutes, which I did. And people came in, and she had to tell everyone, you know, there's no power, can't do anything, and those people are frustrated and left. Some people are nice, some people understand that, you know, it is what it is. But what really started to frustrate me are the people who complain. They're complaining to this woman, hey, I really need stamps, hey, I really need to ship this out, hey, can you just do this, can you just do that? One guy wanted to drop off a package for her. He wanted to leave money, have her ship the package when the power comes on, and then call him and give him her tracking, or the tracking number for the package. That's a little ridiculous, if you ask me. So I'm starting to get frustrated at other people, and that's always been kind of a pet peeve of mine, is when people complain, specifically to, like, cashiers, about something that they can't control. It's just whether, like, an item didn't scan the proper price, and they have to call a manager over to override the price. Whatever the case may be, there's a bunch of different scenarios this can happen. And people get, like, really upset at the cashier. The cashier, it's out of their hands. You know, it's a pet peeve of mine for people to take out their anger at the wrong people. It's just the situation, just what it is. So at this point, I'm 10, 15 minutes into waiting for the power to come back on. Had a nice conversation with the woman. She's actually new. She's only been working there a month. So this was kind of a big test for her, I guess, for work and dealing with customer service, which is never fun. So at this point, I'm fairly frustrated. And I said, all right, well, you know, thanks anyway. And she's apologized. I'm like, it's really not your fault, you know, unlike what other people may think. I understand this is out of your hands. The power went out. It has nothing to do with you. You didn't go outside and knock over a power, you know, a telephone pole or something with your car. It has nothing to do with you. So I said, please don't apologize. It's not your fault. So then I left. And then in leaving, I had to deal with someone who was riding my bumper. I can see the kid. It was a kid in a WRX who obviously wants to go fast and faster than I was going, even though I was going like 5 over the speed limit. And so that was kind of ticking me off. I'm already in a bad place, right? In a bad mood. Jeez, I don't know if you heard that. My stomach rumbling because I didn't have any breakfast or anything yet. So I'm already a little bit annoyed at this point. And now this kid's like just riding me. And then I had to stop again for the tree stuff. And then he's riding me. Then I had to stop again for the road work. They're packing the side of the roads with the gravel because I just paved it. Then I get home. I get this ridiculous text, which again, I can't explain what it is. Sorry. But it's extra, like, this is really frustrating. All right, get ready for it. Here's the kicker. After all of that, I sat in the driveway right here where I sit now, and I made an entire video telling you this entire story, about 15 minutes long or so, only to find out that I didn't hit the record button. So I was talking to my dead phone, or not dead, but my phone that was off, not recording at all. So then I went to hit the play button to play it back, and there is no video because I never recorded one. So this is the second time I'm telling you about my frustrating morning. So, you know, yeah, it's frustrating, but, you know, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? The older I get, the more I realize, like, ridiculous moments like this, you just have to laugh, because what else are you going to do? Get pissed off? You know, ruin the rest of the day? It's early yet. I got a whole day ahead of me, you know? I can't just be upset, because then everything else goes wrong. That's what happens. You know, you carry this anger around, and if you're in a bad mood, everything goes wrong. And everything that does actually go wrong, it seems way worse when you're upset, right? So I'm going to shut the video off. I'm going to do a little deep breathing and go on my day. Oh yeah, before I go, you might notice that I have no neck knife on. You know why? I had to take it off for the post office. This is the same post office that I got yelled at, I don't know, a year ago or so. I did a video, I think, or maybe 2 years, and the woman freaked out that I had a neck knife on because there was a no weapons policy inside the post offices. And that was like a whole thing, which I remembered on the way in before I figured out that they were closed. So I had to go back outside. I had to take off my gun, my neck knife, my whole EDC. I could have tucked it in. I guess in hindsight, I should have just tucked it in, but all my stuff is in my trunk right now. So I could go put it all back on. Anyway, that's all for now. Hopefully you're having a much better day than I am. And I'll see you guys tomorrow with another video. Take care.